Okay, good morning, class.
So today we're looking at the examples for exercise. The exercise, are we on exercise 4 now? Have we done the... No, wait. Just check it. Sorry? On page 72. So we need to do future value annuities that ends early. So the example for exercise 5, in other words, is that correct? So we did the examples for exercise 4. Okay, so let's do examples for exercise 5. These examples on page.
Something wrong with the sound of this thing, so it's open.
It's fair enough to hear. Okay. So we are told if regular payments of an annuity are stopped before the money is required, the value obtained from the annuity formula is the total at the time of the last payment. This total will grow according to compound growth formula until the time that the money is taken out of the account. So basically what happens here, say for argument's sake, you're saving money for 20 years, okay, into an annuity fund on a monthly basis. Now say after 20 years of saving, okay, you decide not to take the money out of the account. However, you also decide not to pay your monthly annuity investment, or the investment, okay? So what happens is, if that money lays another 5 years into the banking account, say for 5 years you predict you don't need the money. So after 5 years of not paying your monthly investment, or your annuity, then what's going to happen is, for that 5 years, that lump sum of money in the account will draw in interest. You guys understand? So basically that is what is happening here. Okay? So firstly, the money, you're doing a monthly payment. After a given amount of time, you decide not to do the payment any longer. However, you're going to leave it in the account to draw a further interest for the next X amount of years. Okay? So let's look at example 1. Example 1 is on page 73. So here we are told that Salwin pays a monthly amount of 1,500 Rand into an annuity, earning an interest rate of 9% per annum compounded monthly for 30 years. At the end of 30 years, he stops his monthly payment but leaves the money in the account for a further 2 years. Calculate how much he had in the account at the end of 32 years. So you all should agree that the future value formula will apply for the first 30 years. Do you all agree with that? So your future value is simply going to be x into 1 plus I to the exponent n minus 1 all over I. Alright. So let's do that part of the formula where the question says 1510 into 1 plus 0.1 0.09/12 to the exponent 12 times, 30th, minus 1, and this is all over I. 0.09/12. So this is the amount at the end of 30th. You only agree with that. Then what happens? Whatever this amount is, so you draw an interest for further 2 years using which formula? Is it the compound interest formula? You guys understand? So then for that part of the formula, so if V is equal to this amount here multiplied by the interest rate for the next 2 years. Okay. If you wanted, you could have worked out this value here. You guys understand? But I worked that out, and then you could have added the product factor for 2 years. But I'm going to do one calculation, so I do everything in one. So it's 1 plus I, which is 0.09, and this is all over 12, to the exponent 2 times 12. So let's put that in the calculator. Let's make sure this is not behind the calculator. This remove the calculator. Okay, so the 12 is just behind. So, okay, so let's put that in the calculator. So you say 1,500. We have put 15,000 on the stakes, is 1,500. Into open brackets 1 plus 0.09/12 the exponent 12 times 30 minus 1, this is all over 0.09, that's over 12, open brackets, this product factor here, that is take place for 2 years, 1 plus 0.09/12 to the exponent 2 times 12. I get 3,285,000. 489 rand and 41 cents. Okay. 3,285,489 rand and 41 cents. Okay. See any confusion there? Please look at number 2. Number 2 is on page 74. The area told that Tandy opens a savings account and immediately deposits 1,000 rand into the account. People, if the deposit is made immediately, so what happens here is an extra installment. Not so. So there's a variation on n, so it's going to become n plus 1. Okay. 1 month later, thereafter, on a monthly basis, she invests 1,000 rand per month for the period of 3 years. 1 month after the final payment of 1,000 rand, Tandy increase her monthly payment to 2,500 rand. So if she does that 1 month after that final amount of 1,000, which is in conformity with the formula. Remember that the last deposit is made on the expiration of the determination of the investment. Okay. So that is also in order then. So we are told that Dan increases a monthly payment of 2,500 rand and continues these monthly payments for a further 3 years. The interest rate during the 6 year period is 10%, so it's a flat rate of 10% per annum, compounded monthly, which is also in conformance to the deposit or the investment frequency. Calculate the further value, the future value, sorry, of this investment at the end of the 6 year period. So what happens, people? We're going to first consider the 1,000 rand for 3 years. And remember, it is 1 month prior, ne? Starts immediately. So it's n plus 1. So again, the future value is equal to x into 1 plus I to the exponent n minus 1 over. So I'm just going to consider that for the 3 years first, plus 1 month. So your future value is simply going to be x into 1 plus I. Sorry, we know x is 1,000 n. Into 1 plus I, your interest rate has a flat rate of 10%, so 0,1 over 12, to the exponent 12 times, it's for 3 years, and it starts immediately, so it's plus 1, so that will just give me 37, minus 1, and this is all over I, which is 0,1 over 2. But what did we say? What happens there? They will, this amount, you see that the frequency or the installment value, okay, your x value is changing in this formula. Can you see that? It is changing. So this formula only accommodates when the amount is standard. Not so. But because it's a change in the formula, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that amount that has been saved, and then I will draw an interest on this for how many years. Will you draw an interest for 3 years? You guys understand? Okay, so you're going to draw an interest for 3 years. It says 1 plus 0,1 over 12, the exponent 12 times 3. So that is taking care of the 1,000 rand that was invested for the first 3 years plus 1 month. And then I draw the interest. Okay, for 3 years. Then what happens? Then he's drawing 2,500 rand for the remaining 3 years at the same interest rate. So what formula do we use there again? Again, future value. Not so. So it's plus this 2,500 rand into 1 plus 0.1 over 12 to the exponent 12 times 3 minus 1. And this is all over I, which is 0,1 over 2. Okay. Let's plug that into the formula. 1,000 rand into 1 plus 0.1 over 12 to the exponent 36 plus 1 is 37 minus 1. That's over 0.1 over 12. Open brackets. 1 plus 0.1 over 12 to the exponent 12 times 3, which is 36. Loop. Plus 2,500 into 1 plus 0.1 over 12. Okay, so it's not like this. To the exponent 36. Okay, the calculator is not allowing us. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, you see this interest here. What I could have done was one of two things. No? I can either work out that in red first and write that answer in and press the answer button thereafter. Or what I'm going to do is I'm going to put all this, I'm going to program that first into the calculator as the last answer calculated. And And then whenever I see that, I press answer. Okay. So it says 0.1 over 12. Okay. So whenever I see that yellow, I'm going to put that answer. Alright, so let's go again. It's 1000 Rand. Open brackets. 1 plus. I could have actually put the whole thing in the calculator. So that is the same thing, it's typed up all the time. Okay. I'm going to close the calculator. So let's go again. So it's 1000 Rand. Open brackets. 1 plus 0.1 over 12. So that in yellow is worth, that is equal to 1 to 1 over 120. So let's try now. So it's 1000. Open brackets. That answer, which is that yellow, to the exponent 37, plus or minus 1, close the bracket, in the denominator 0.1 over 12. You see, if I programmed the calculator at 0.1 over 12, I would have written that also typed in answer. Okay, but it's fine. So open brackets, that answer. To the exponent 36. You don't need a bracket. Okay. 1 plus 2500 Rand. Open brackets, answer to the exponent 36 minus 1. That is over 0.1. Gives me 162,601.64. Okay, so that's the future value. Right, you guys understand? So with that, you should be able to do exercise 5. Okay, and exercise 5 is on page